everyone. I'm Karen. This is Karen Puzzles. And today I have the long promised third video in my series about the 1000 Colors Puzzles. This one is going to be about the Vibrating Colors Puzzle, which is similar to the Halftone Puzzle that I showed a few weeks ago. Just like the Halftone Puzzle, this is the same gradient as the original 1000 Colors Puzzle, only what they've done is they overlaid a polka dot graphic over the entire thing, and the colors of the polka dots are the exact complementary color of the background color of the puzzle piece. So at times, this makes the colors seem to vibrate. Yes, it is very trippy, and yes, it did give me a little bit of a headache. So the thing about this puzzle is that it is both the most challenging of the three puzzles and also the least brightly colored. You can see how having the complementary color over the whole thing just kind of dulls the color. It makes it look kind of gray, at least at a distance. But as always, let's start at the beginning. Let's start with the box. I got this puzzle in 2017 at the same time that I got the Halftone puzzle, and they are essentially the same box, just with the name changed and the picture on the front changed. And I have to say, even though I do wish they had put more information about the puzzle on the sides or the back of the box, I do love how simple all of the boxes look once they're together. I think they would look really nice displayed on a shelf as decorative items. So let's look at the pieces. You can see how all of the pieces have this polka dot overlay pattern on them. Some of the colors are easy to differentiate, and then some of the colors are much harder to look at. But the quality of the pieces is solid, and even though I've done this puzzle multiple times over the years, I haven't had a problem with any of the pieces peeling up or getting damaged. So when it came time to sort out the pieces, this was such a satisfying way of making order out of chaos. This puzzle is probably the most difficult one to sort that I've done lately, just because there are so many colors happening that it was tough to get a sense of the gradient beyond just sorting it into piles of a yellow background versus a pink background versus a blue background. But eventually, I got through all of the sorting, and then I realized that the gradient that I sorted the pieces into isn't the same gradient as the puzzle, like the colors aren't quite in that same order. So I had to be constantly moving pieces back and forth over the main section of the puzzle, which was kind of annoying, but you know, I got through it. It's not the fault of the puzzle. And after doing like the third version of this puzzle, I really should have known what order the colors of the gradient were going in. So the thing that this puzzle reminds me so much of is those brain teasers where they've written out a list of colors, but in different colors than what the colors say. So I had to be like actively telling myself that I was looking for a piece with a yellow background and blue dots because my brain would just keep reaching for a piece with a blue background and yellow dots. And I had to be very like methodical about making sure that I was reaching for the right piece and not one from the opposite side of the puzzle. The whole thing just got very confusing in my brain, but you know, I think that's fun. Okay, so it is time for a little color theory lesson. There is a term called luminosity, which is basically our perceived brightness of a color. So even at equal levels of saturation, we will perceive yellow to be brighter than blue. So in this puzzle, the colors that have very different luminosity levels, which are the yellows and the blues, they were definitely the easiest parts of the puzzle since the contrast between the colors was pretty high. You could pretty easily see what you were doing and tell the colors apart. However, when the luminosity gets more similar, like with the pinks and the greens, that's where the colors really start to vibrate That's the part that's probably gonna give you a little bit of a headache. When you're like staring at this complementary colors polka dot pattern, it really does seem to vibrate at times. I had to keep looking away to give my eyes a break from it. But just like the other 1000 colors gradient puzzles, I do love how you can basically just pick a spot to work from, and then as you're working out, the gradient is so gradual that you blink and suddenly you're halfway across the puzzle and the colors are totally different from where you started. So I think that out of the three versions of this gradient puzzle that I've featured here on this channel, this vibrating colors puzzle is definitely my least favorite, just because the colors feel a little bit more dull, even though they're actually the same brightness as the other two puzzles, just because of the complementary colors being next to each other, it causes all of the colors to feel more dull from a distance. It took me the longest amount of time to do compared to the other two, so this one took me about 2.5 hours. The other two versions each took me about 2 hours. So if you're looking to get the most puzzling time for your money, this one would be the way to go. If you're looking for a super bright, colorful image to hang up on your wall, the other two would definitely be more apt for that. I'll also say that since the pieces have so much going on, like so many different colors happening, I didn't really enjoy playing with them as an art piece as much as I did with the other two. But I mean, of course, that's just kind of a bonus factor. That's nothing to do with the puzzling process itself. But overall, I do really like it. I'm just saying that the other two are some of my favorite puzzles ever. This one isn't quite at that level, but I still think it is a very, like, interesting, innovative idea for a puzzle, and I really enjoy the challenge of doing something like this. So, once again, I'm not going to go through all of the pricing since I covered all of that in the first video about the original 1000 Colors gradient puzzle, but if you haven't seen that, just the basics, this puzzle, not cheap. It is currently on Amazon for $43, which is about the same price that you'll pay on their website, because basically the company that makes these is based in Australia. So if you're in Australia, all of the puzzles are actually cheaper, but if you're in America, like I am, you know, it costs money to get them all the way over here. And they're a small company. They're allowed to charge whatever they want, and these are really interesting, like, art pieces. So I'm not saying that this price is, like, unfair or anything, but, you know, it's something to be aware of if you decide that you want to try these out. So basically, if you love gradient puzzles, if you're trying to collect all of them and you want something different, you know, you want another twist on that idea, this is a great choice. If you are brand new to gradient puzzles, I wouldn't necessarily say that this should be the first one that you get. I would say definitely start with the original 1000 colors puzzle. But I would love to know in a comment right down below if you've ever done this puzzle, or if you think it is something you enjoy, or if you prefer puzzles that have, like, actual things happening in the picture and not just a solid texture or gradient over the entire thing. So if you're watching the whole video, your code word for the comments is color wheel, and then I'll know that you watched the whole video, and you'll be my favorite puzzler that ever existed. Yeah, I think I can say that. Every single one of you that watched this whole video, you're my favorite puzzler that ever existed. All right, I need to go. This puzzle clearly got to my brain. Happy puzzling. I'll see you all next time.